Clone robotics has just set a remarkable milestone in human history by unveiling the first ever biomimetic system. This full-body android can reproduce human anatomy and movement with an accuracy we've never seen before. In today's video, I'll take you inside Protoclone V1's android technology and explore what it means for our future. We'll journey through the robot's groundbreaking features, including its advanced sensor system and natural movement patterns, and compare it to previous humanoid robots. Get ready to learn about the technical specifications, potential use cases, and ethical implications, showing how close we are to the lifelike robots we've seen in science fiction movies. Clone Robotics' release of Protoclone V1 on the 19th of February 2025 marks the beginning of a new era in robotics. When we think of robotics, we often picture traditional humanoid robots built on rigid, mechanical frameworks like Boston Dynamics' Atlas and Tesla's Optimus. However, Clone Robotics takes a refreshing and innovative approach with their Protoclone V1. This remarkable creation stems from an in-depth understanding of human biology and the complex systems that enable our movements and functions. Rather than merely mimicking the human form, Clone Robotics is focused on redefining functionality, paving the way for a new system in robotic design. The robotics lab has opened up exciting possibilities for the future of robotics by focusing on how robots can operate and adapt, rather than just how they look and function. The Protoclone V1 is a step in this direction, suggesting that by embracing the complexities of human biology, we can push beyond the conventional boundaries of what robots are capable of. This shift enhances the potential applications of robotics and encourages us to rethink the essence of what it means to create machines that work alongside us. So, what innovative technologies and design principles make Protoclone V1 so unique? A major feature that sets the Protoclone V1 apart is its incredible musculoskeletal system. It's unlike anything we've seen before in robotics. Rather than relying on traditional metal bones and stiff joints, this innovative design utilizes 3D-printed polymer bones that closely mimic human anatomy. These polymer bones are lighter than their metal counterparts and provide enhanced flexibility, allowing for more natural movement. Contrary to conventional methods, the Protoclone V1 uses more than 1,000 artificial myofiber muscles to contract under pressure and imitate human muscles on a microscopic level. Traditional electric motors are heavy and inefficient, but these innovative muscles provide a remarkable power density while allowing for smooth, gentle movements. Meanwhile, degrees of freedom in robotics imply how many independent ways a robot can move. The more degrees of freedom a robot has, the more adaptable and versatile it becomes in its movements. For instance, a standard industrial robot arm usually has around 6 degrees of freedom, while more advanced humanoid robots might boast anywhere from 30 to 60. But then there's the Protoclone V1, which takes things to an entirely new level with an impressive 200 degrees of freedom. This level of flexibility and movement opens up possibilities for executing complex, human-like movements we haven't seen before. If you think that's impressive, wait for the next feature. While modern robots rely on electric motors, Protoclone V1 uses the hybrid hydraulic pneumatic system. It supplies the myofiber muscles with liquid and air for contraction using printed network hoses. An artificial heart, a 500-watt pump, provides the essential high pressure for driving the system. I find it novel how hydraulics and pneumatics combine to power the entire system in Protoclone V1, especially considering their unique advantages for biomimetic applications. Hydraulic systems can generate high forces while allowing for precise movements, which is impressive. On the other hand, pneumatic systems shine with their rapid response times and flexibility. As a result of integrating both systems, Protoclone V1 achieves a remarkable balance. They allow for powerful and sensitive movements, much like how the human musculoskeletal system operates. Here comes another incredible feature similar to how humans feel their surroundings. Protoclone V1 requires an advanced sensor system to sense its body and surroundings. That's why the Clone Robotics team equipped the robot with 500 sensors strategically placed all over the robot to measure and optimize its strength and position in real time. These sensors are always at work, sending continuous data to the control system, which cleverly adjusts the activation of the artificial muscles to execute whatever movement or action different scenarios require. It's shocking and spooky to think about how this feedback system mirrors our human proprioceptive system, allowing us to sense where our body is and how it's moving in space, all without needing to look. Isn't that incredible? What's more, it's common knowledge that complex artificial systems generate so much heat, especially when working hard. Most robots rely on fans or heat sinks to keep cool, but the Protoclone V1 takes things to a new level. It features an innovative cooling system that channels liquid through porous materials on its surface, allowing it to evaporate and mimic the cooling effect of human sweat. I find this technical solution clever and a great example of how clone robotics draws inspiration from nature. Are you enjoying the video? Then give it a thumbs up. I'd also appreciate it if you subscribe to this channel. Also, hit the notification bell so you never miss our latest updates. Now let's get back to the video. Instead of sporting a detailed human-like face, Clone Robotics chose a minimalistic and functional appearance for Protoclone V1. It features a black visor with a faceless design. I think this design choice likely stems from the concept known as the Uncanny Valley. For those unfamiliar, the Uncanny Valley refers to that unsettling feeling we sometimes experience after seeing humanoid robots or computer-generated characters. They look almost human, but have slight differences that make them feel off, disgusting, or even creepy. It's like our brains are wired to pick up on those little discrepancies, and they can trigger discomfort. By opting for a less realistic face in Protoclone V1, I believe Clone Robotics is trying to avoid this awkwardness and create a greater acceptance of these robots. It's all about making them more relatable and easier for us to embrace. Additionally, the rubber skin that encases the inner workings of the Protoclone V1 plays a crucial role in enhancing its overall look. Not only does it safeguard the delicate internal parts, but it also lends the robot an organic feel that beautifully complements its biomimetic design. This outer layer helps create a more polished and less mechanical aesthetic, making the Protoclone V1 feel almost alive. It's a perfect blend of technology and nature. Now, what are the possible areas of application for Protoclone V1? The Protoclone V1's human-like appearance and ability to move around make him a perfect fit for household chores. Imagine having someone who can whip up your favorite meals, keep the place tidy, handle laundry, and even carry things from one room to another. With the power of AI integrated into his system, he wouldn't just be capable of following simple commands, he'd navigate the twists and turns of a busy home environment all on his own, tackling tasks with ease and adapting to whatever surprises might come his way. Another potential use case is care and support. As our society ages, the demand for nursing and care services is on the rise, and I can't help but think about how humanoid robots like the Protoclone V1 could make a difference for older adults or those in need. They won't mind having a companion that assists with daily tasks, provides social interaction, and even lends a hand in emergencies. Think about how these advanced robots could enhance the quality of life for many and bring peace of mind to families, knowing their loved ones have support when needed. Protoclone V1 also has great potential in various industrial and production settings. Picture a humanoid robot that can tackle complex assembly tasks, maneuver through tight spaces, or even work in dangerous environments. These robots could help human workers by taking on those physically demanding or repetitive jobs that can wear us down. As I sit here contemplating the introduction of the Protoclone V1 into our daily lives, I can't help but draw parallels to the world painted in the movie I, Robot. You know, that gripping film where robots were designed to serve humans, but eventually raised questions about autonomy, ethics, and trust? It's unsettling to think we might be heading down a similar path. First off, let me say that the Protoclone V1 promises some incredible advancements and use cases. But then I start thinking about the implications. What happens when these advanced machines become too integrated into our lives? Are we relinquishing control over our own decisions? In iRobot, the idea of robots making choices based on their interpretation of human safety led to unintended consequences. Are we prepared for a future where a machine could prioritize logic over alignment with humans? And let's not forget about privacy. I find it chilling in the movie how much data the robots collected about their human counterparts. With the Protoclone V1 constantly learning from us, what kind of information is it gathering? How secure is that data? We live in a world where breaches happen frequently, and it's hard not to feel uneasy about having a device so intimately involved in our lives. Could our conversations be recorded without our consent? Would our preferences be used against us or sold as data to advertisers? What do you think? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button and subscribe to this channel. And don't forget to tap the notification bell so you never miss an update.